Howdy and hello folks, my name is Christian Sasser, but you can call me MH4, and today I'm going to be doing my first ever video game review. And what better way to start it than with a JRPG, Persona 4 Golden.
Persona 4 Golden originally launched on the PlayStation Vita in 2012 and was essentially an expansion of 2008's Persona 4. In summer of 2020, Golden finally escaped the Vita and launched as the first ever Persona title to hit the Steam storefront. I've never played this game before, but I have heard good things, so this review will be as blind and unbiased as it can possibly be. And I should mention that this review will spoil the entire story of the game, so if you haven't played it yet, please click away now. Still here? Great, let's keep going.
And special thanks to Atlas for allowing me to be the first person to announce this, but they have just announced a physical version of the game that you can play handheld.
First of all, let's discuss the build quality of this model. Unfortunately, it's not great. It's a little bit scratched and beat up looking, but it gets the job done nicely. It doesn't look the prettiest, but it can still play Persona 4 Golden, and that's what matters. Now onto the game itself. The story does this interesting thing where it's a normal, linear story, but you can skip back or forth to any point in the story you want. Nothing changes, this game isn't choice-based or a strategy RPG, but it's a nice addition that lets me relive my favorite moments. The characters are just alright, nobody truly stands out to me. I do enjoy Bob, who does very funny and quirky things such as inspecting an Andy Warhol painting and holding his teddy bear named Tim. However, the ending of Bob's arc has him become the King of England, and it feels a little bit forced. I enjoyed it, but I wasn't too happy with it. The story itself was just alright. It feels like the plot of a children's film made by Illumination, not worthy of Atlas's caliber. It's very strange, but that's not to say I didn't enjoy the story a little bit. The story is a bit short compared to other Persona titles. Additionally, the ending is an ad for P5 Royal, which was a bold move, but ultimately one that I can respect. The graphics are sparse, with most of the game being text, but the black and white graphics are a bold choice that I can really respect. There's an odd portion in the middle of the story that sort of recaps the beginning and includes screenshots from the anime, and these screenshots are in color, so they stick out like a sore thumb. They should have fully committed to the black and white style. It looks incredibly stylish, and the colored portion seriously breaks the flow of the story and stylization. Another stylized choice was the exclusion of any audio whatsoever. While I can respect this choice artistically, I think even some minimal sound effects and music would have gone a long way to help boost the mediocre storytelling. Also, aren't Persona games most known for their music? I don't know, I guess I'm just a little confused. Hopefully they patch some in later down the line.
Overall, the game is just a huge mixed bag. Sometimes it's incredibly artistic, and other times it's just incredibly childish. Can't decide what it wants to be, and the just alright plot and characters are highlighted by the game's lack of sound. The game is seriously carried by its unique presentation and provides good enough entertainment, but ultimately, your time is better spent elsewhere. 5 out of 10, go watch the anime instead.